That's definitely less than the last one. Oh, are you okay?
What's up, everyone? So first off, we would like to acknowledge that we plagiarized this idea from a few students a few years ago who also did BLS Hot Ones. They did the exact same format, chicken nuggets and everything. But don't tell Mr. Gallagher we plagiarized it, or else we might be in trouble.
Yeah, we're gonna have to bring this up and see if this was academic dishonesty or not, so.
Okay, so how are you doing?
You know, I'm nervous.
Okay.
I'm nervous, but I think I got this.
So first, we're starting with the spicy buffalo. I might warn you, it's pretty hot. Let's dip in. Cheers.
Cheers, man.
Cheers.
Is it bad?
No, it just tastes like a very bland hot sauce.
All right, that's fine. We got a champion. He'll be able to do the rest of them just fine, mm-hmm. Then.
What? That one's hot?
So this is your first year at the school.
First year is at school, yep.
Yep. Obviously, you can't get to know everyone, mm-hmm. So we would just like to start off with questions to get to know you.
Okay.
So the first one is kind of like a question that determines what kind of person you are.
Okay. Uh-oh.
This is a very serious question. The okay. student body may be really mad at you if you get this one wrong.
Oh, goodness.
What All comes right. first, cereal or milk?
Oh, yeah, it's cereal. Yeah, cereal first. I eat cereal every morning for breakfast, and cereal goes in the bowl first, then the milk goes in.
You yep. hear that?
No.
Mr. Gallagher will hunt you down if you put milk first.
Well.
Expect a call to his office. You wanna get moving to the sweet Chipotle?
This one here?
Yeah.
All right, you wanna pour, we gonna pour it out, or what are we gonna do?
Yeah, we're gonna pour it
on
out
the plate?
On the plate, yeah.
All right. So, now it's my turn.
Okay.
So, how's your day been, Mr. Gallagher?
Pretty good.
Yeah, so.
Getting better, right?
Yup. I saw you handle the first level pretty well, so now we're moving on to Chipotle.
Okay.
So first, I guess let's choose.
Cheers. Here we go.
Dive in.
Chipotle, huh? Let's get some Chipotle on there.
All right. Actually, I'm gonna follow your lead. I'll get right up in there too. That's pretty light.
Yeah. Usually like Chipotle sauce, I don't think that one's that good. What's the name again? Chipotle what?
This one is sweet.
Sweet?
Yeah, sweet.
I don't taste a lot of sweet in that Chipotle.
Yeah, that one's a little bit on the more mild end for sure. But
Huh.
Yeah, so one question we had was, what's your favorite thing in the office?
What's my favorite thing in the office?
Yeah.
Hmm. I guess staff isn't a thing, but I love the staff who work in the office, as well as all the prefects who work in there. We have a great team in there who work hard, but they're also very positive people, easy to talk to, and when things can get a little bumpy, they're funny and they make me smile and make me laugh. So I know staff and students aren't a thing, but I think those are my favorite things in the office.
Definitely shout out to Ms. Pierce and Ms. Hernandez.
Yeah, Ms. Pierce, Ms. Hernandez, Ms. Follin, and then all the prefects as well.
Of course.
They're a great team.
Yeah, and then I had a second question. So what are your favorite movies, or do you have like a favorite artist you like to listen to?
So for asking about my favorite movies, I like movies with fast zombies, like, you know, like 30 Days Later. What else is it? Fast zombies, like World War Z. You know, I like zombie movies, but I like fast zombies. Like, is anyone watching The Last of Us? It's not a movie, but
yeah,
it's on HBO.
Yeah, okay.
Like, you know, the type of zombies and that when they're fast, like I like slow zombies, like Walking Dead. It's like,
yeah.
Well, let me walk real quick to get away from the zombies. I like the ones where they're like fast and they have like the rage and that type of stuff. So those movies kind of give me nightmares and stuff like that.
Okay.
So what would you bring to a zombie apocalypse?
Yeah, what would you bring?
What would I bring to a zombie apocalypse?
Yep.
Oh goodness, that's a really good question. I mean, bring me in, like, do I have to fit in a backpack, or?
As long as you can carry it.
If you can bring one person and one thing with you, then
Yeah. One person to one thing. Oh my goodness. I guess, if I could bring one thing, I guess like maybe like a flashlight. Yeah, because I'd be worried at night walking around in the dark, and if there's an apocalypse, there's probably no electricity, so I wouldn't be able to see. And if I could bring one person, I don't know, somebody fast. I have to bring somebody fast so they can run in and out and get stuff for us, like maybe like Usain Bolt or something like that, or you know, somebody with speed who can, you know, hey, I'll be the lookout, you run and go get it type thing, because that's not me.
I thought personally you might bring a tank or something, but...
Bring a tank?
Yeah.
So well, I didn't think I'd a tank on my person. Like, I could bring a tank, yeah.
I just thought you'd be able to go. You're right.
Yeah. But now that we're at Boston Latin, like, I know, I always used to think of this when I was here, like, as a student, and I always think, like, when we talk about, like, the Gallic Wars or anything involved, like, Caesar going, was like, I would love to go back to Roman times with a tank. They do throw towards the Avenue and stuff like that. Like, imagine going through Rome. We would conquer Rome in a day with a tank. So this is ghost pepper?
Sorry. Ghostly garlic.
Okay, so this is just gonna give really bad breath. Oh, but there's a pepper sign on, so it's fine. Okay.
Here we go.
All right, let's see what we got here. Wow, that's garlicky.
Try another one. Okay. So can you tell us a little bit about your time here as a student?
Yeah, it's good. It's a little bit too much garlic for me, though. I'm glad I don't have a date tonight or something, because this is, like, offensive. I was pretty quiet as a student. I think if you ask kids I went to school with, the reason why people might remember is just from being on the basketball team. I was all about basketball. Basketball was my favorite thing. I was a average student here. I was no threat to get into Harvard, that's for sure. But I worked hard. I mean, I had to work hard to do okay here and like to graduate. Obviously, we didn't have like the number of AP courses and stuff like that we have these days, but I was able to take a few AP courses, but I was pretty quiet, stayed out of trouble, and just did what I needed to do. But I think at the time, playing basketball was a big part of it. I was president of the Charles Barkley fan club and made sure everyone knew that. You know, you guys see him on TNT doing the games all the time now. But Latin school was a lot different back then too, though. I think it's a much better school now. It was a great school back then, but I think it's a little better now. But I tried to fly under the radar and stay out of trouble.
Okay, so adding on to that,
okay,
what was your favorite memory here?
My favorite memory at Boston Latin School, as a student or just at Boston Latin?
Just as a student, and we can talk about like this year as a administrator as well.
Okay. My favorite memory at Boston Latin School, I would say, I remember like there's so much about senior year that was so much fun, whether it was everything around prom, whether everything around like the excitement of going to college. Like I was the first member of my family on either side anywhere to ever go to college. So getting accepted into college was a really big deal. Going to college was a really big deal. Like that was so important to my family. It's something that they really valued and they were so happy for me. That was an important thing for me because, it just made that year so special. But it definitely my entire senior year, everything about it, whether it was the basketball season, the prom, being able to go to prom with friends, just being in classes with students you've known for 6 years. I think senior year as a whole is just one of my favorite years of my life for sure.
And then what is your favorite class or what class you recommend all kids here taking?
You know, there are a lot of classes here that weren't available that they weren't available when I went to Latin. When I see like Capstone or like Myths, like those are the classes that I know I would have taken when I was at Latin school. And, Miss Foley did something at a school parent council meeting us where a lot of teachers talked about their courses and they were incredible courses, but Myths is the one course that I wish I could have taken while I was here, but we didn't have it as a course. But while I was at Latin school, my favorite class was probably AP Government. I liked AP Government. It was a good teacher and I learned a lot. I was excited to be in an AP course as well because I never saw myself as a student as smart as all the kids who took all the AP courses. So that was a course that I remember. Yeah. Most probably.
Unfortunately, this year I got rejected from both Capstone and Mitt.
Sorry to hear that.
So yeah, so I messed up. I don't remember what side this is. The calamity pain.
Okay.
I have no spice tolerance. Like zero.
Okay.
You have no spice tolerance?
Yeah, like zero.
Okay.
It's this one, right?
Cheers, everyone. All Cheers. Right, hey, you can dip in for us now.
Okay, guys, okay.
What flavor is this one?
This is good. This is good.
That's definitely less than the last one. Oh, you okay?
That's our thumbnail.
Yeah, that one's okay.
Anyways,
no. What are some things that you regret doing as a student?
You know what? I don't know if there's a lot that I regret doing. I think there might be some regrets that I have that I didn't do. Oh, actually, I should say this. I do regret not continuing on with, I started taking the clarinet as a sixie. The music director at the time, his name was Mr. Harper. I was so bad at it, and I swear to God, I practiced so bad at it that he recommended that I stop. And I wish I hadn't done that, because now when I see I see students here working on instruments. I had this dream that I was somehow going to be like a saxophone player someday. And I never took an instrument back up, and I regret doing that for sure. But other than that, I wish I had worked just a little bit harder in every class and got grades that were a little bit better, you know? I hope this is because of the sauce, not because I was told I was terrible at the clarinet. Yeah.
I have the same.
No, I'm okay.
Did you really?
Yeah, I played piano for 7 years, and then like I quit because I was really tired. And now that I'm here at BLS, I see so many people that are going into these big leagues because they can play so well,
yeah.
And I get so
yeah.
jealous. And I'm like, oh, I could have been that.
Yep.
But it's okay.
Yeah, no, that's definitely a regret I have that I stopped doing that.
Okay, next we have the Ghost Pepper Pepper Place Palace. Made with the world's hottest chilies. I doubt it.
Oh, ghost pepper. I don't think I've ever had ghost peppers. This one.
$17 is crazy.
I keep looking over this to DeVelis to kind of give me a
I can't even do here, sriracha. I can't even handle sriracha. How am I supposed to? What happened to your Asianness? It went away. I can't use chopsticks either. Yeah.
Okay, maybe you should just stop speaking.
So can I go on to the hot questions?
You ready?
Can I go on to
the hot questions? If you do hot, you guys know.
What do you mean, can you translate this passage?
Oh, don't ask me.
Okay, you would ask me to give a back.
Okay.
All right.
Ready?
Everyone dip in.
Here we go. Oh, you giving it a go? All right. I love the bravery.
You want to have a little bit more?
No. What the heck?
Oh, that one's tough.
The pepper is there, but there's no flavor.
I know. It's hot, but it's not something I would ever like put on something.
Yeah.
It's like almost made for just the challenge instead of like, oh yeah, that one. It continues to be.
Okay. So tell me, now that you're a headmaster here, after a few years you've been gone, how has Latin school changed?
That's a good question. I get asked that a lot. And the first thing I'll say here is there is a ton more support for students than I've ever seen here before. I think back when I went to Latin school, it was more of like you came into Latin and you were kind of seen as like you have to get through here on your own and it's really hard. And there wasn't a lot of extra support. Teachers were good, but they didn't spend as much time supporting students outside. Guidance was much smaller. I would say the level of support there is for students has is probably the biggest change that I've seen. No doubt about that. Yeah.
Is that like a good improvement that you think, or can it improve more?
I think it's something that we have to continue to get better at, but it is significantly better than what it was. It's just something we want to continue to grow at for sure.
Okay. So.
Yeah. That one's still kind of hanging out.
What are some things that you think that you can change about BLS?
Well, I want, excuse me for a second now.
You're good.
Yeah, it's got a later kick than I thought I was going to get. Can you repeat the question?
What are some things that you are planning to change about BLS?
Well, I don't know. I can't sit here and tell you there's a ton of things that I want to change. I think there are things that we do well that we want to do even better. Like things like student support, things like us working together as a school, in certain areas to make sure that everyone's get everything they can out of Boston Latin School. I think we need to make sure that everyone feels safe, everyone feels welcome, everyone feels like they can be successful, and that we have the supports there to help people do that. So I don't think there's a lot that we want to change. I think there are just a lot of things we want to try to get better at. Like, I also want to get better at other things. Like, I want our clubs to have more access to things after school. I want our sports teams to be better. I want our arts program to be better. So all of those things, right?
Great like answer.
Because we're good at a lot. We want to move from good to great, and that's the steps we have to take.
So true.
What's this one called?
This one is called...
Let me see.
Ghost in the Darkness.
Oh, boy. Mm. I can sit on script if you guys want me to.
Yeah, oh, good. It's low in carbs. Right.
I'm Mr. DeVelis. I'm here to eat nuggets with sauce.
Here we go.
Yeah, this is the extra hot round, and I'll be asking my boss some questions. Okay. First...
Cheers. All right.
Which one is it? This one?
That one, yeah. Let's see what we got there. All right.
Is it this one? That one? Let's do a Ghost in the Darkness.
I don't find this one to be as hot as the last one. What was the one before this? The ghost pepper? I think the ghost pepper was a little bit hotter.
Should we have another one?
No. I know I have another one coming up.
Okay. So, a question for you. I'm sure you have many great memories at this school. What is your worst memory at BLS?
Yeah, that's an easy one. I think I talked about it at the rally, missing a shot to win a basketball game against the English high school. Mm-hmm. I will never forget that. It's the first thing I think of every time I walk into our gym. The first thing I think of, and I will never forget it. There'll be times I get up every morning, I go for a run. There are times I'll be out for a run and I'll listen to music and it'll just pop in my head. It has stayed with me since the age of, I think I was 16 or 17 when I missed that shot. Mm-hmm. I'll never forget that.
It's
my
PTSD.
I mean, I'm not tortured by it. I don't mean to sound like someday. I'm going to be, you know, walking in circles saying I missed the shot, but it's something that really bothers me because it was our big rival. But that's my worst BLS memory.
Mm. Okay.
Absolutely no doubt about it. All right. There's a little more kick a couple seconds later. All right, now I can.
It's definitely a linger, right?
Yeah, it's a lingering one. There's no doubt.
Yeah. Let's see. What's the funniest thing that's happened to you while you're here?
The funniest thing that's happened to me while I'm here, that a group of students got me to sit at a table, try out different sauces, and eat chicken nuggets with milk.
All right.
This is a pretty funny one right here.
This is peak.
Yeah, I don't know. I have to think about that. I don't know what the funniest thing that's happened. I get asked a lot of funny questions from people.
Okay,
about Latin school. People who don't have any connection to Latin school, they'll ask funny questions all the time. And, I will say that there was one question that I could have taken as a little bit offensive, but I realized it was taken from someone who was really ignorant of what Boston Latin School is all about and what it's like for our students here. And he was asking me about the violence and gangs in Boston Latin School. And I had to turn that a little bit sideways and think about what to say to him before I started saying, well, if you want to talk about a group of students, you know, in the gymnasium wearing purple shirts and throwing a ball into a hole, then we have gangs of basketball players, or we have gangs of kids walking around with calculators doing math, and we have gangs of kids singing together on stage that we call a choir. And so I kind of turned it around to him. I was like, yeah, we have groups of kids who do it together all the time, and if you want to call those gangs, you can call them gangs. But it was someone who, when he asked the question, I had to think of a way because it disarmed me a little bit. So. That was an interesting one. There were a couple students there when he asked me the question too, and I was like, okay, this is them right here, and you're asking about their school. Yeah, so that one was a little irritating.
Good pivot.
Yeah.
Finally, this is a really important question to ask. It's a great measure of a man's character and also kind of what they...
Sounds like a milk cereal
question. What they really believe in. So my question to you is a hot dog a sandwich?
Oh my God. I've been asked that by a student. I was asked that by a student earlier this year. Well, there's bread, right? Mm-hmm. And there's something similar to meat in that bread. Mm-hmm. Is a hot dog a sandwich? I'm gonna say no, because I've never heard anyone say, "Do you want a hot dog sandwich?" So I don't know. Like I can't put it in the same category as like a steak and cheese or a ham and cheese or a chicken palm or something like that. I don't know. Is a hot dog a sandwich?
I can show them the sandwich alignment chart.
That is a pretty convincing chart. Not only that, but you use some of the great things that we have as far as food, such as the Choco Taco,
R.I.P.,
the burrito.
Right.
I will say this, though. How'd you come up with the purest neutral PB&J sandwich?
Well, because it fits all the shape of a sandwich. It's usually on two pieces of bread with something in the middle, but it has a savory component and a sweet component. It has both PB&J.
Okay.
And so it's not exactly dessert. It's not exactly fully lunch. Right in the middle.
Good argument. Good argument. So you're asking me the question again, is a hot dog a sandwich?
Is a hot dog a sandwich?
According to this reasoning, it clearly is a sandwich. Okay. What, the last one?
Yeah. All of us should be the last one. Please.
That'd be
fire.
Yeah.
Okay. Maya, if you...
And this one is like straight up fire, right?
This one is the hottest.
No, I know.
This one's extreme, according to the label. All
right.
Wait, let me shake it. Okay. Pour a lot.
Oh,
why is it so hot?
Let's see what happens when it cross contaminates there. Does something happen?
Probably nothing good. I would say.
You want to try it? All right, let's go. Okay.
You're mixing it with
the
other one.
I'm sorry.
All right,
let's get up and eat.
Okay. We in?
Yeah. All right. Let's start with our first
question. Are we all gonna eat at the same time?
He already started!
Girl!
Everybody eat it. Everybody eat it.
Hey, go! I think. Uh-huh. Go? Okay.
Tell us about a time you broke the rules at BLS.
I never broke the rules at BLS.
Hypothetically speaking.
Hypothetically?
Let's say an evil version of you appeared. Of you as a student, what rule would he break?
I don't know if I want to give anyone ideas. You mean like if your bus didn't show up at your stop, that you took your time coming to school and stopped for breakfast or something like that instead of going right to school? I would never do something like
that. And no student watching BLSTV should either.
Nope, it's the wrong rule to break. Don't do things like that.
I can't believe you would suggest such a evil idea.
I always try to get my way here as quickly as possible so I can miss as little time as possible. If a bus didn't show up.
Guys, don't come late.
Broke down.
7:45.
Have you ever used Latin in your adult life?
In a conversation? Like, have I talked to someone or just used Latin? In
outside life? Of anything relating to Latin school or having been like, I know Latin.
Yeah.
Has it ever had any practical effect on your life?
Yeah, have you ever watched Jeopardy? You can be really good at Jeopardy if you're strong at Latin. So yes, Latin has a lot of reasons, good applications outside of Latin school.
So can you decline the first declension then?
I think we should move on to the next question because this is starting to get to my...
I understand.
Media, so don't ask me questions about declining anything in Latin.
What's the greatest lesson that you've learned at the school?
The greatest lesson?
Yeah. And what piece of advice would you give?
Yeah, that's... So like, I think the lesson that I learned here, and I hope it's something that students take away here, is 6 years or 4 years if you're busy, 6 or 4 years of like really hard work with good friends and with good teachers, right? The lesson is like, you leave here, you're ready to do, you're ready to go on to college, and you will make lots of friends with kids from other schools and states or whatever, and when you go to college, you're gonna be harder working than them, you're gonna know more than them already, and this is just fact, right? And college, like, was easier for me than Latin school was. Grad school was easier for me than Latin school was because it prepared us for what was next. And it's not that college is not easy, but here you learn how to work. So I learned here at Latin school, I learned how to work. I learned how to balance my time. I learned how to like write essays and take tests. And a lot of other schools, even their top students, they're not as well prepared for what comes next as even students here at Latin school who are just average Latin school students like I was. I mean, I was, and even my own two boys, I mean, my favorite thing about Latin school is like, I love being the head of school and I love being a student, but I think my favorite thing was being the parent of two Latin school students, two good Latin school students. They went to college and they like destroyed college, like destroyed it. Like it's, and they didn't go to Harvard. You know, one's at Merrimack, the other went to Mass Maritime, but no worries about getting through college, like none at all, because they were prepared from being here. And that's the biggest lesson about Latin school. Like you leave here, even if you're an all A student going to Harvard, or if you're a student who struggled and had C's and D's and maybe even failed some classes, you're gonna go to a college and you're gonna be successful there, because that's what Latin school does. There's no doubt about that. You can ask all of the alum who you might know who do that. They go to college and like, it's compared to the work we do here, it's doable, it's workable, and you stand out among students, there's no doubt about it, no doubt. And you can talk to valedictorians at schools that you go to who might have gone to a suburban high school that probably did pretty well, and they'll be great students. You will see that your work ethic is better, you have a better knowledge base, you're better prepared, and that's because of Latin school. That's the biggest lesson I got from here. Yeah, that can't be argued. That can't be argued.
Okay.
Those weren't too bad. I mean, I could still feel them, but you know.
Well, if that's all from you, I guess that's all from us.
Do you want ice cream? We can give you a little reward.
I guess a little ice cream wouldn't hurt, right?
I think that pack only has like two spoons. I can't find any more spoons.
There were eight in that pack.
Chocolate right. Fudge.
Do you have anything else you want to add?
Shout out to see if there's any like.